In this video, we will look at how to calculate the mean, median, and mode in RStudio. I'll start by creating a collection of numbers that we can use as an example. I'll just use 5 numbers to keep things simple, 97833, and I'll call them X to make them easier to manage. So with that as our test data, let's begin with the mean. To calculate the mean, we need 2 things. First, we need to know how many numbers there are in our group. Supposing we didn't know that there were 5 numbers in our group, we could use the length function. So we could say, what is the length of X? And it lets us know that there are 5 numbers in our group. Next, we need to know the combined total of the numbers. So we could ask, what is the sum of X? And we can see that the answer is 30. So we just need to divide 30 by 5, and we get the mean, which is 6. And if we wanted to do that in one line of code, we could say the sum of X divided by the length of X, which would give us the same result of 6. Now, while it is good to know how to do things step by step, RStudio has a pre-built mean function. So, simpler still, we could ask, what is the mean of X? Now on to the median. To calculate the median, we need to put our numbers into numerical order and then select the number in the middle. Let's start by viewing our numbers, which we can do with the view function. Here it is clear to see that we have 5 rows of numbers. Therefore, the number in the middle is the number on the 3rd row, which in this case is the number 8. And rather than doing that by eye, we could ask RStudio to tell us what number lies on a specific row by using square brackets. Therefore, looking at X on row 3, we can see the number 8. However, our numbers are not yet in numerical order, and so this is not necessarily the median. We first need to use the sort function, as this will put our numbers into numerical order for us, and then we can ask RStudio to tell us what number lies on the 3rd row of this sorted version of X, which would give us the median, which is the number 7. However, while it is a good exercise, RStudio also has a pre-built median function. So we could simply ask, what is the median of X? Now on to the mode. The mode is slightly trickier because R doesn't have a pre-built mode function in this sense. However, as with the mean and the median, there is a manual way to find it out. And to do that, we need to see what number appears most often in our collection of numbers. Now, we could just view our numbers and count them manually. We can see that 9, 7, and 8 appear only once, but the number 3 appears twice. Therefore, as the number 3 appears most frequently, it is the mode. However, some groups of data could have millions of numbers, and so it is not always practical to do it by eye. But fortunately, RStudio can help us, and the way I like to do it is with a table. If we create a table of X, in the top row, it shows us the numbers that we have in our collection. And in the second row, it tells us how often each number appears in the collection. So we just need to create a table and then ask RStudio, what is the highest number on that bottom row? As this will tell us which number has the highest frequency. And we can do that with the which.max function. And so we start with the table function, as this will provide us the frequencies. And then we put that within the which.max function, as this will tell us, of the frequencies, which is the highest. And therefore, this will give us the mode, which in this case is the number 3. The number 1 below it just tells us that on our table, it was the first column. This goes to show that sometimes in RStudio, there is a pre-built function that does exactly what you need. But sometimes you have to think outside the box and do a little bit of a workaround. Hope this helps. I'll see you in the next one.